Australia's leading sports organisations have made a pledge to tackle youth binge drinking.
Now when you watch your favourite sports like football,
basketball,
swimming,
netball,
and Australian uni sport,
you won't see alcohol sponsorship.
You'll see this logo.
Because the less exposure young people have to alcohol promotion,
the better.
We're strong enough to say enough.
And you can be too.
Back your judgement.
Stand up for what you believe in.
Be the influence.
Bit wet, so they're going to have to just change the way that they make these passes a little bit here going into the second half. I'm sure it'll dry out fairly soon.
Okay, so as we see Flanagan take over, just getting a replay of that goal in the first half, and Messant it was, managed to get behind the defender, and Emily Smith was in the right place at the right time. So that's how the Aussies have got their lead. And as I was calling the replay, you were watching the play there, Jade. What happened?
Play worked around the left-hand side of the circle, and Messant, again, featuring. Got a hold of the ball in the circle, reverse stick shot onto one of the Koreans' foot or feet.
Okay, so penalty corner number 4 for the Aussies. There are the Koreans getting the protective gear on. Crazy, I think, Jade, that players don't wear the face mask, that some players elect not to wear it.
Yeah, I think they're crazy too if they don't.
When you have the opportunity to. I know in the olden days, I suppose, that gear wasn't around, but now they have the opportunity, and what can you say about that, Jade?
I mean, I mentioned that the pitch is a little bit wet. They seem to have overwatered it in the halftime break, but oh, I'm not sure that there's much of an excuse for that.
Does that qualify as a boo-boo?
Yeah.
Okay, boo-boo. Well, Kelly White won't
she
be...
She needs to move on from that.
Yeah, absolutely.
Get on to the next thing.
Well, we were speaking about that in one of the previous games, weren't we? Not dwelling on errors and also unfortunate things that have happened to you in the game. As I said that as you took a big drink of water, so...
Yeah, I did, yeah. And I think
Not sure we need a replay on this, but no one wants to see that again. Thanks, boys at the desk. Sure, Kelly won't necessarily want to see that. Okay, well, under pressure there was Kim momentarily, but handled it well, as the Korean defenders have for most of this series. Cha sends it backwards. This is Oh again. Ball through. Kim goes the aerial route. Haven't seen a lot of that today, which is an indication of how free-flowing this game has been.
Yeah, it kind of is indicating that there's not a huge amount of pockets of space that they can throw them into, and you want to make sure that you are landing a ball like that into space. Otherwise, it basically becomes a defender's ball, really, if it's two people under the ball that's landing. The game, or this second half, hasn't really started with the same tempo that the first half ended in, which is probably not a bad thing at this stage. Hockeyroos just patiently working the ball around.
And, well, that came with some power from Cha, really wound up on that slap hit, unfortunately, for Korea, just out of the reach of Chun there. So Aussies take over. Yeah, just a quieter start to this second half. Maybe the players looking to conserve energy here.
Quite possibly.
It has
cooled down a touch.
The
cloud covers come over, so it's a touch cooler.
Here's Jenna now. Goes with the overhead. Attard waits for it. Collects it now. Cross is in. It's gotten through. Nance gone. Nelson. And Nelson scores. Ash Nelson pounced on that. She had to be patient in the end with the shot and eventually scooped it through. And Korea have been broken once again. And this time it is Ash Nelson getting on the score sheet, doubling Australia's lead. They had to work hard for that one, didn't they? But it came for them in the end, Australia.
Yeah, you certainly can't underestimate a hit across the circle. I think maybe teams sometimes don't use it enough, or I mean, again, can overuse it, but, you know, a little mistrap by a defender, miss swing, whatever, means that the players like Ash Nelson, who's so good at just lurking in the dangerous spaces, can jump on it and get a quick shot away.
Okay, here it is. Initial shot was parried away and had the temperament there, Ash Nelson, to go with the second effort and get it across the goal line. It was Nanscorn initially that crashed in that probably created a lot of that disruption in the Korean defence, wasn't it?
Yeah, and like I've said before with Georgia, she's so low and so quick on her feet and quick with her hands, so any little disturbance in there, and you know, to put the defenders either wrong-footed or just can't quite see the ball is helpful for the other teammates.
Well, Ash Nelson has scored 3 goals in this series so far, 43 over the course of her career. Certainly been very productive up forward, hasn't she?
Mm-hmm, definitely.
All right, here she is with the ball now. Cast in the defensive area at this stage. No doubt be keen to get up and get on the score sheet again. Flanagan. Johnston sends it back to Flanagan. Once again, the Koreans stay off the Aussie defenders, give them room to move. Here's Blythe now down the side, trying to build something for Australia. Good tackle, though, and she's dispossessed. And once again, they try to pinpoint a long ball just out of the reach of Chun. She gets a seat on the pine, and Cho comes on the field. Is Flanagan. Well, she'll take that as a pass. Again, that's gone off a Korean stick.
Behind you, Madonna.
2 balls on the field. Have to get rid of one of those. Here's Johnston. Works it back. A little bit of pressure here for Joyce to deal with. No problem for her, though. Flanagan has to reach for it. Ball onto Claxton was not too bad. A little bit difficult to handle. Missed trap.
Good trap.
Yeah, that's a good trap. You heard it through the effects mic from Joyce.
Yeah, umpire appreciated that trap, didn't she?
Absolutely. Running down the sideline. Nelson will get it back now. On the baseline, flicks it back to a dangerous spot. No one there, although close, did very well. That was Williams, and shot on, I think, from Nanscorn.
I think that was Nelson again.
Nelson again, yeah. Followed up. She's everywhere at the moment. And they put the pressure on the Koreans here. No panic, though. Close in skills. We've seen this a lot from them.
Long corner.
They've been okay.
Back out, Red. Hold out.
And penalty corner.
I call. Hold out.
There you go. You heard the explanation loud and clear. Alyssa Trivik. Love to see that. Umpires explaining their call. How'd you see it? You happy with the explanation?
I don't know. To me, I wouldn't let that play on because there were both teams within the 5 when she took off with the ball. So if I was out there with this, I probably would have said, hold up, wait for both teams to get back. But look, she's well within her rights to, you know, she was
just
instructing.
Please,
and the Korean didn't obey.
Here,
so.
Right in the box,
their punishment, another penalty corner.
Okay, all right, penalty corner number 5, the last
Thanks,
attempt.
Thanks, 19.
Well, wasn't particularly glorious.
Ready?
I noticed that Nelson's taking the responsibility as the ejector on this occasion. Ball's in play. Flanagan has a swing and a miss. So, another opportunity. Not taken by the Australians, and now they've got some work to do defensively. Korea have moved this well forward, and can they get a shot away? It was Char. She came all the way down from defence, but couldn't get herself on the score sheet there. Now the Aussies come back at the Koreans. Parker goes for a run. Nearly an intercept. Doesn't matter because Char has picked it up for the Koreans. Oh, foot race on here. Cho can't beat Johnston back. Johnston does it very well. And Flanagan now. Just for a moment there, I thought Cho had the run of it. And Johnson cut across.
Yeah, and going back to that penalty corner, how often do we see that a defensive corner down your end can then result in almost a decent goal opportunity there? And the Koreans, I think, will be a little bit disappointed that that missed trap on the baseline didn't result in something a little bit better.
Yeah, certainly looked dangerous on the counter, haven't they, once again? They would be disappointed not to have got at least a goal so far with the opportunities they've had. They've had quite a few good ones.
Yeah, absolutely.
Okay. Whistle. It goes Australia's way, just outside the D here. Here's Blythe. Forces it into the D. Whistle goes the way of the visitors, though. Off to the races now is Hong. Held up by Attard, though. Attard putting good pressure on and winning the ball. And her cross to Messett was good. Just a little mistrap. Let's Kim in. And Kim will take the free hit. Thought about blasting it forward. Decided against it. Wasn't a lot happening up forward, so they decide to set things up from the back. This is Ahn. Char now. Nanscorn. As Messent. Messent looks forward. Smith, well, had it behind her. Didn't do much with it. Coming back the Korean way now. Little deflection onto Kim is good. They could be away here. There is a player in the circle for them. They hold things up. Cross comes in. It's out wide. Gives Ahn a really good opportunity. And took a deflection as well on the way through. Nearly on the post. Once again, somehow, they've managed not to score on what was a very good forward thrust there.
Yeah, really, really well-played build-up to that shot at goal. And the thing that really set that one off is the midfield transfer. Coming down the left-hand side, but getting that ball across to the right where there is a lot of space, because generally your defensive team will flood across. So very well done there by the Koreans, but again, another opportunity gone begging.
Okay, Kim on the march. She has her namesake out wide, doesn't use it, goes more direct. They are held up and it's in to the side of the net. So thought they could have maybe done better there, painted herself into a corner there. Did Hong and couldn't get a good shot away. Lee in the midfield. Looks like they just might have lifted their rating a bit though, Koreans. Two goals down, 22 minutes to go. So, that's a missed pass in the back that lets Australia in. Is Nanscorn going the wrong direction? Little half intercept works out, lands with a teammate. Now she'll get it back. Will Kim? She has Cho in support in the circle, doesn't use her, tries to run the baseline herself. Thought a little flick back may have been more useful there.
Yeah, I think every time that she put her head up, her fellow striker was just out of the pass, and then when she put her head down, she was in the pass. So it was that kind of indecision of not exactly knowing where she was, but probably something a little bit more effective than what she did would have been better.
Well, they worked that one out fairly easily there, the Australians. And now it's messing a little dump back to White. White has drawn a crowd, still moving it forward though. Now she wins herself a whistle. Ooh. Just what's happened there?
Korean looks like she's taken a little swing, but hit her own player.
Oh, dear. Friendly fire. She's up. No harm done. Now, I know this is a message that you're very keen on, Jade. Be the influence. Tackle binge drinking. Big supporters of this Korean series here.
Yes, yeah, we do thank them for the support, and we certainly are big advocates of that campaign.
My efforts on that regard, Jade. We'll have to wait until tonight.
Sure.
After I relapsed last night. But it's certainly a very good message. As we see a mass of changes here. And got a break in play here. Fritz Ferguson, what is going on here?
James, I'm not too sure what's going on with the game, but one of the Koreans, Ok Joo Kim, has gone down with a very sore back and looks a bit like going into her hip as well. So she's getting some treatment down here in the tunnel. She's got some ice and a physio down here working on her.
Okay, so the clock has stopped. And there is Ok Joo Kim having a... No, it's not. There's Ok Joo Kim. Thanks, cameraman. There she is getting some work done. Hopefully that's not too serious, Frizz. We might get you to report back in a bit later on to find out the prognosis there. So getting a bit of work done. So the man down at the moment are certainly on their rotations, the Koreans.
Yeah, probably not something that you'd like when the game really does have a fairly high tempo. But also in that break, I think Tony Kronk was fixing something up on a pad. So gave the Aussies an opportunity just to regroup and have a bit of a chat about things that they might be able to fix, well, particularly in the next 5 minutes, but going into the rest of the half.
Yeah, that's, funnily enough, an opportunity that the Koreans didn't take. They remained separated while the Aussies huddled up.
Please, that's fine.
Okay, position is set. Now there's an opportunity overhead. One in hope, really, just landed with the Aussies and they've conceded the ball. Attard into Nanscon, got the deflection, close has it. Her shot was partly blocked. Still on target, though. She'll get it back now, close.
Look, a beautiful receive by Tennille Attard in the centre of the pitch there. Often, if you can receive the ball and beat the play at the same time, it's the best kind of elimination method, I suppose. You don't really need to take someone on because you've beaten them in the trap. So, yeah, really well done by Tennille there.
Okay. With the ball now, Lee is Park. Shows a good clean pair of heels to her opposition, still going and still has it through three defenders there. Little flick on and they get a shot away and it's just wide. Dare Kim was there after the great work from Park, really scything through the field there. The dangerous Korean skipper, but shot was just off target from Kim. Another great opportunity missed there from the Koreans.
Yeah, Park showing her strength. Even though there were tackles placed on her, she still managed to keep the strength on the ball and pull it away from the defenders.
You love to see that, no matter what side they play for, a player backing themselves, taking on defenders and finding a way through.
Yeah.
Great attacking play can really make the difference. And, well, miscommunication there from the Koreans. Nobody home.
Jesus. Sorry.
And
there was one behind you, guys. Okay.
Ball comes back. Two balls on the pitch. Flanagan good to go now. Speaking of backing herself, she does. Gets it under close. Quick flick forward. Williams was there.
Yeah, no. It's for the danger. It's for the danger. The ball going up.
And, well, there you heard the call. Line. Penalty corner. Ball went high.
Yep, I think Mel just wanted to blow the whistle there quickly. I think her left hand went up first, but then realised that it was actually off the Korean defender or goalkeeper possibly, but that draws the corner for Australia.
Morning, yeah, Williams getting involved as well, the debutante.
Thanks, girls. In the box, please.
Stymied ultimately, but did enough to get the corner here. Penalty corner number 6, none for Korea so far in this game. Here's Nelson, deliberate setup, ball's in play, trap is on, Flanagan has it, Lee sticks out the big juke and knocks it away.
The big juke, that's a new one, I haven't heard that one before.
Here's close, okay, they can work it out, the Koreans. And will they do enough to get it to the sideline? Yeah, must have taken a deflection.
Excuse me.
A red ball. And There'll be a whistle here, will there? No, she flirted with it, Melissa Trivik, I think.
Yeah, I'm not sure what. Maybe I think she a was bit trying of to chatter. See if there's a ball. Oh, and then a ball down the opposite end.
Okay.
They really are conscious of not letting the ball put in play if there is another ball on the field.
Here's Lee. On to Ahn. Bit of room to work with here. Can they create something? The Koreans. Here's Park. Park. Jenna gets a stick in, disrupting Park's plans. Now Park gets it to Ahn. Still haven't cleared the D, and well, they won't because they've conceded a penalty corner off the foot. First penalty corner of the game to the visitors. As We Will Rock You reverberates around the Perth Hockey Stadium.
Yeah, I can't be held responsible for that one.
It's looked like we've turned up to a Wildcats game.
Yeah.
All of a sudden.
Oh, it'd be great if we had that kind of atmosphere. Those games are phenomenal with the amount of noise and
they certainly
such
are.
A good atmosphere.
If we were, we'd have people at the behind the goals now, cheerleaders waving pom-poms. That would be. Is that something hockey needs?
Oh, I don't know about that.
Certainly, as you say, add to the atmosphere. Maybe not so much to the dignity of the sport.
No.
Anyway, the Koreans, they can have their penalty corner without the disruptions from cheerleaders and fans. And shots on its way. It was from Char. Did it find its way through? It didn't. Wow, how did that stay out? Once again, well, Tony Cronk was there.
Yeah,
I don't know how that didn't get through.
Well, she put it into her own play. You see number 22.
She's down, yeah.
Park.
Another injury.
Dealing with probably a cork at this stage.
Well, they're letting the play go on. She needs to get out of the way quickly here because the ball's coming her way. And ball's out of play, which is fortunate because they can stop the play. And we're going to get a replay on what happened here. Ball goes through.
Chloe.
Yeah, oh. Her own player denied it. That adds an insult to injury, doesn't it?
Cop one
looks like on the knee or just above. And not only that, she's prevented the goal for her side. Gee, that's the double whammy. She's hopping off. And not in good shape. Korea already have a player down, and now Kuji Park.
Yeah.
Has copped a very nasty blow.
Well, they've got the magic spray out.
The magic
sure
spray.
Does
that actually work?
I have no idea.
You've never had it applied?
No.
Oh, you've been lucky. We'll have to ask her after the game. She's being assisted around the sideline here. There's Park, so I know she's. So she'd be able to go mostly off her own steam, and she's nearly copped another one on the side there. The ball's just following her at the moment. Get her out of the stadium. Jeez, dangerous.
Yeah, ball magnet.
Absolutely, but once again, I don't know. Is she the victim of her own circumstances there, being in the way of that stroke? As we see a steal here, and Kim gets through, and her little dump on to Chun. Somehow, once again, they managed to deny themselves a goal, the Koreans.
There's a fair amount of... here we might see the body contact in this one here from Flanagan on...
Fair old
good
hip
nudge.
And shoulder, yeah, absolutely. Yep. No call. Happy with that decision?
Well, you know, I'm pretty sure if I was a forward, I wouldn't like it, but...
You're a defender,
so you're happy
with it.
Well, luckily, there's no video replays.
Absolutely.
Well done by Nance Gorn.
Yeah, still going. Nance Gorn gets it on to a teammate, Emily Smith. And as easy as you like, Georgia Nance Gorn sets up Emily Smith for her second goal of the game. Australia go up 3-0 and racing away with this game. They have managed to keep Korea out somehow over the past few minutes. And, well, that really hurts Korea now, doesn't it, when they go down the other end and have one scored against them.
Yeah, I mean, that was a little bit against a run of play, but we love it when we see our strikers really want to take on the defence and little manoeuvre there by Georgia was great in setting up
absolutely.
M for the goal.
Well, here it is here. Well, only caught the tail of it. The work initially prior to that was even better, but everything executed right there, wasn't it?
Yep.
And Emily Smith was there to profit. All she had to do was put it away, and she did that very effectively. Her second
That's
goal
fine, play, play.
Of the game. Back to that Korean penalty corner, if I can briefly,
yes.
Jade. Park was hit, but should have she been standing there in the first place?
Yeah, I'm not sure. I mean, we're on a little bit of a...
As we see, that ball was raised up. And easy decision, so it's all happening. Just no time to reflect on anything. Kelly White has worn one here, so...
Well, while we have this little break, yeah, in the previous corner, not sure, we can't really tell on the angle here, but I'm going to think that she might have been just outside the post. Generally, when you're running in for that deflection, it's to get in the way of the sweeper or the person standing on the right post for the defence. And I'm going to suggest that maybe it was going a little bit wide. And maybe if she'd got a stick onto it quickly, it could have deflected in. But look, just a little bit unlucky, I think, in that instance.
Yeah, absolutely. Okay.
So what are we at, number seven?
Yep. Penalty corner number seven for Australia.
Seems to be a trend in these games.
It is, yeah. Seven in the past two games as well for the Aussies. Still over 10 minutes to go in game three here. The Aussie battery awaits. Flanagan takes it. Doesn't go very far. And they haven't cleared yet. It's coming in with interest from Nanscorn. And a deflection of Madonna Blythe. And the floodgates have opened. 4-0 now to the Australians. Well, that was just a case of just sending it straight back in.
Yeah, look, a really good pick-up by Georgia, just inside the 25. And for the girls that were still in the circle, being prepared and ready for anything that might have come through, and really nice little touch there by Madonna. I think it did end up coming off a defender, but look, anything going towards the goal, there's a chance that it could go in. So well done by Madonna.
Yeah, absolutely. So 4-0 now, and the resistance of Korea has well and truly been broken. As we see the replay on it, here's Georgia getting it back in quickly. And we'll just see here. Didn't quite see that, but Blythe flicking it on, getting a goal. There's another player that loves a goal, isn't it? The skipper.
Yeah, she does. She had a bit of a drought there for a while, I think, Madonna, so she'll certainly be pleased that fewer going in for her now.
Scored in all three games so far.
Yeah.
Here's Claxton. Close is up ahead in the middle. Doesn't use her. She does now with an overhead. Has Kim to beat. Does close. Tries to find her way through. Wins herself a whistle. Messon bursting away through. Nelson with a shot. Took a deflection. Bounced over the goal. So all of a sudden the Aussies, well, they're rampant, aren't they?
Yeah, look, and just getting a couple of goals in there really certainly lifts your confidence, and trying a few different things.
Nelson,
maybe
another opportunity. Oh, a little, well, timely tackle. It's going to come back, and it's from Claire Messon on this occasion. And, well, we spoke about how much she loves a goal. She gives it a big triumph salute as she sends in goal number five for the Aussies. And, well, what can you say? They've broken the Koreans wide open now.
Yeah, they certainly have. And we always talk about the goal-scoring positions in the circle, and she was perfectly placed in one of those just then, just off to the left-hand side of the top of the circle, and a really good, quick shot, which is...
Okay, so here is the replay. Ash Nelson initially. This tackle's superb, but doesn't do the Koreans much good because it comes straight back in. Pass in, and there is Messon with some clear air ahead of her, and all she had to do was put it away, and did it very nicely. Nothing the keeper could do about that one. The Koreans, can they get something out of this game now? Since they probably should have been in front, or at least level pegging at half time, that wasn't the case. Haven't made the most of their opportunities today, and now they find themselves, well, five goals down. It's not pretty reading. But 7 minutes, 10 seconds remaining in the game. So no doubt Australia will win this now. And just a skill error from the Koreans there. How much was it spoken about prior to the last game, that the loss that the Aussies had? Was that a motivating factor, or was it something that's, you know, just part, you know, you just accept that?
No, it certainly wasn't acceptable, I don't think. And, those were a few of the words used by Adam Commons, was that, you know, unacceptable and we need to take responsibility for it. So, look, it certainly did come up in the discussions, and, you know, it was just how do we then move on from that? Bury it, leave it, and let's move on. And I think they've responded really well today. Fortunately, here we see the Koreans with a PC opportunity.
Stick check, Anna Flanagan. They get a penalty corner opportunity. So a chance for the Koreans to salvage something out of this game. Just having a turnover in staff here. As Cha comes all the way down from defence for the push here. Okay. Can they get themselves a consolation here? Oh, takes it. Blasts it in. Kronk. Well, she was in the way. Not much they could do about that one. Still going, though, the Koreans, and win themselves another corner here.
Yeah, Melissa was certainly indicating what she thought she saw, which was a foot. I think Madonna might be just letting her know that it was came off a hand, not a foot. So anyway.
Well, either way, it is a penalty corner. And take two here for the Koreans. Was in play. No.
I have no idea what happened just then. This is all a bit confusing.
All right, Luke. All right, well, Jade, you're here for the expert comments. And
yeah,
the,
no,
the
I thing, just saw Donnie running out to the...
If you don't know, I've got no idea.
Sure, unless you double-touched it, but I was looking at the girls in the goal box.
Either way, it's Australia with the ball, yeah. And missed opportunity. That's a great pass from Flanagan onto Nelson. Nelson trying to centre, coughs it up. And the Koreans will be able to clear here. This is Cha. Going to wind up one of those big long balls. Doesn't do so on this occasion. Goes to Kim. She does hit it forward. Ball's in dispute in the midfield. The Aussies win it. Flick on from McMahon to Parker. Parker's ball's pretty good. Williams lets it go for close. Got called out of it there. So good communication there from the Aussies. And close. Sends it to Attard.
Hey!
Attard. It's through to Nelson. Turns around, winds it up. Straight to the keeper. Still goes Nelson. She'll get another opportunity here. Can she force one through? She can't. Coming in was Blythe. And what about that? That's some sort of a goal. And just persistence from the Aussies. They forced the shot. It was initially saved. But they couldn't save it from Madonna Blythe. She came in. Sliding shot. Yeah. Love that one. You loved that one, Jade.
Did.
Taylor.
Got a good clap for that one. Well done, Donnie. Look, it's showing that they're really determined to get the ball in the back of the net now. Any one of them could get in there and have a really good shot. So, look, it's good to see that they're all wanting to get a piece of the action now.
Yeah,
and look, at 6-0, you'd be pretty pleased with this performance now. Certainly a turnaround from the first half anyway.
Yeah, certainly. Similar sort of pat. All right, here it is. It was Nelson doing a lot of the work. This is after she'd already had a shot saved. Goes again, the scramble ball.
It's a 16, just inside.
Well, they cleared it, kind of, but...
That's it.
Well, look at this. You won't get much better than that.
No.
Fantastic stuff, Madonna Blythe. What a great highlight that is. So
it's here, please. Thank you.
Really sticking the boots into the visitors now, the Hockeyroos. Little miss trap, we'll let them in. Here's Blythe again. What's she got ahead of her? Decides to hold on to it. Now goes to Messent. She goes, tries to go back to Blythe. The Korean's in the way. Falls with Nanscorn though. Nanscorn. Cross in. Danger ball. They haven't cleared it. Another shot on its way.
Madonna in all of the action at the moment.
She sure is.
She'll be very happy with her performance today.
Forcing a save from Lee, the keeper. He's been beaten 6 times today already, and there could be more to come in the remaining 2 minutes here. Aussies really with their tails up at the moment. Little pass on from Claxton was good.
Oh, that straight up into
shot, shot led a lot to be desired from the debutante. And if you're wondering at home, that is not a goal to Korea.
No. I see Tony Cronk getting well out of the way, just in case it did. Because if it did clip her and it went in, that is now considered a goal.
Yeah. Here's Jenna.
No, miss trap.
Deflection off her stick, fell to the Koreans. Cho has it. Tries to cut across, stick in there from Claxton. Be okay though for the Koreans because Cha will clean up. Hong has it. Runs the sideline. Now the cross in. Korean ball just outside. Aussies will clear here, or will they? Nanscorn, good contest there with Lee. Nanscorn wins out, charges forward, has Parker. What does Parker do? Retains possession, looking to...
Messent, I think, on the ball now.
Messent, my apologies, yeah. Into Nanscorn, coming in is Williams. And, the flick on from Nanscorn, just had too much on it. Little jab at the ball. Went over the crossbar. Well, really all over the Koreans now. How do you assess this performance as Williams diving in to disrupt? The Aussies will win it 6-0, and they take the lead in the series. But wonderful effort, wasn't it, from the Aussies today?
Yeah, absolutely. Look, they'll be very pleased with the way that they closed that game out. At halftime, it really could have gone either way. So, look, they obviously had a good chat at halftime, sorted out the things that maybe weren't working all that well in the first half, and it came out firing in that second, and they'll be really, really happy with the finishing off of that game.
Yeah, absolutely. The goal just prior to halftime, in a sense, was vital because the Koreans, you felt, were on top in that first half, but then for them to go into the halftime break in with a deficit would have broken their morale a bit, you think?
Yeah, and we talk about like critical moments in games, and that certainly was one of them. And if that one hadn't maybe been converted, then that indecision really starts to creep in, and then it becomes more of a mental battle rather than just physically getting out there and doing your job. So look, that M. Smith can be credited for that little turning point of the game, and look, they certainly rode off that momentum and took it into the second half.
Yeah, absolutely. Well. Goal scorers were Emily Smith with 2, Claire Messent with 1, Madonna Blythe with 2, and Ash Nelson also getting on the board. 6-0 to Australia. They seem pretty happy in the camp down there, don't they?
Yeah, they will be. And coming off the performance on Thursday night, which wasn't the best, but look, they'll be happy with this one.
Let's go down to the coach. Over to you, Frizz.
Thank you very much. I have Adam Commons here with me, the head coach of the Hockeyroos. Congratulations on the win. That was a massive second half. What was the message at the break?
Yeah, look, we thought we needed to just be more patient. We needed to move the ball around, and we needed to do it really sharply and find different areas of the field to get the ball. And the girls did that well, and they executed well in the attacking circle.
Now, Madonna Blythe had some time off, and she's come back now in fine form. What do you make of that?
She's been training really well, and she needed a little bit of a break after the Olympics. She's somebody that's played a lot of international matches. She's someone that's been there, done that. She's had a long career. She needed to have a few months off, but she's come back in great form, and we're really pleased with where she's at.
And game four tomorrow, what can we expect to see then?
Well, look, I think the Koreans, they'll certainly learn from that. They'll come out with a different game plan. They'll look at what they can do to try and make it difficult for us, and we'll need to find the solutions to what their game plan and look to improve on that performance.
And you've got a fair bit out of the juniors in the team as well, a few Gillaroos joining you. How has it been working with them?
Oh, it's been wonderful. Look, the juniors coming through, they're really talented. They're a good young group. They've got a long way to go. They still need to learn a little bit about how we play senior international hockey. But we've been really pleased with their enthusiasm and their energy.
Excellent. Well, thank you very much. Good luck for tomorrow and enjoy the shootout.
Thanks a lot.
James, back to you. Or are you joining me?
Yeah, I'm going to stand over here today, Prison.
Thank you.
Do it just with Jade. Jade, fantastic effort by the Hockeyroos. On now. There we go. Fantastic effort.
That's
okay. Hockeyroos really came out and showed their stuff today, didn't they?
Yeah, look, it certainly was a tale of two different halves, I think. You know, the first half they probably wouldn't have been all that pleased with. Would have assessed things at half time and then, you know, put into place the changes that needed to be made. And look, the result is, you know, a 6-0 win. So they'll certainly be pleased with the way that they finished off the game in the second half.
Yeah, certainly a lot for the Koreans to think about now. Had a few injuries as well. Hopefully nothing too serious now. They've got 24 hours to reassess. Anything they can do to come back and level the series up?
Yeah, look, I think the Aussies really just got on top of them in terms of their physical presence and the way that they really ran the game out with speed and you know, getting at them quickly. But look, the Koreans certainly had their opportunities in the first half, and they'll certainly be looking to exploit the space that maybe the Aussie defenders leave for them in behind. So look, they'll I'm sure that they'll go to the video and have a look at things that they might be able to do going into tomorrow's game, because they'll be looking to level up the series.
Yeah, absolutely. Looking forward to that game. Jade, once again, thanks for having your company today. Thank you at home for watching, and we'll join you again here from the Perth Hockey Stadium when we bring you Game 4, 2:00 Western Standard Time.